I'm going to show you how to put your phone screen on your YouTube video so it looks like this. And it's really easy to do, and we're going to use a free app to do it. Now, this is something I get a ton of requests for. Anytime I do a mobile tutorial and I put my phone screen on my video, people want to know how I do it. So I'm going to show you how to do it using a totally free app. And in order to do this, you're going to need three things. So let me tell you what those are. The first thing you're going to need is a screen recording. That's obviously what you want to put up on the screen. And if you don't know how to do this, I'm going to put links down below so you can learn how to do this on an Android and an iOS device. It's not going to cost you anything. It's really easy to use. So check those videos out if you don't know how to do that. Now, here's the thing. This doesn't have to be a phone recording that goes up on your screen. You can put another picture. You can add another video. It's entirely up to you what you want to put on your screen. The process is exactly the same. So even if you're doing reaction videos and you want to put a recording of the reaction up here, you can do that as well. Or memes or emojis or whatever you want. This is entirely up to you. But for this video, I'm going to show you how to put your phone screen up there, but you can swap this out with any image or video that you want. The second thing you're going to need is a phone screen. And these are also easy to come by. Head over to Google, type in your make and model of phone, followed by transparent PNG. You're going to find a ton of options here to choose from. Just make sure that you use one that is royalty free so you don't have any copyright issues in the future. What you want to do is download that file to your phone, but please make sure it is a transparent PNG or it's not going to work the way you want this to work. So download it to your phone and we're going to access that in just a minute. The third thing you're going to need is a free mobile video editing app called ENLIGHT Videoleap. Now, if this name sounds familiar, it's because they're one of the popular apps that get recommended anytime video apps come up. And they're also the same company that brought us Facetune 2, the beautifying app. So you've probably seen that. That's always at the top of the video apps anytime you're looking for the best apps. So that's probably where you've heard Videoleap before if it sounds familiar. Yeah, and I could probably use some of that Facetune beautifying. You think so? You think I could pretty this up? No? Now, if you don't have Videoleap installed yet, head down to my description. I'm going to put links down there so you can download it and install it for free. Then once you do that, go ahead and open it up and let me show you how to put your phone screen on your YouTube videos. When you first open up Videoleap, you want to look at the big plus icon down here at the very bottom. This is how you're going to add any of your clips or photos. I'm going to tap on that and I'm going to go find the video track that I want to lay as my base layer. And I'm going to build everything on top of this one. And by the way, you can look down here at the bottom. I've created a folder called Assets, but you can go into any folder in your gallery and choose the clips or photographs that you want to use in your video. Then once you're in the correct folder, tap on the video that you want to add. I'm going to tap on this, then I'm going to tap Add to Project down here at the bottom. Once this loads up down at the bottom, the next thing I want to do is I want to scrub along here on the timeline by pushing and moving around until I find the place that I want to add the phone. Once I find the location where I want to add the transparent phone PNG file that we talked about a little bit earlier, I'm going to tap on Mixer right down here on the bottom. Then I'm going to go in and I'm going to select that file. Now you're going to see that it just put that file right here on the top. This is the white image that dropped on top of my video inside the timeline. So the first thing that I want to do is size it to the correct size. Now, depending on where you downloaded the image and the actual size that you imported it as, you might have to pinch and zoom to get it to the correct size that you want. But for me, I know the correct size already. So I'm going to go down to the bottom and I'm going to scroll to the right until I see transform. I'm going to tap on transform and I'm going to go over and tap on fit. And that's going to make it go full screen. And again, if you have a different size, this might not fit properly. So you might have to pinch and zoom. The next thing I want to do is drag out this image for as long as I want it to play on the video. And I do that by tapping on the image here in the timeline, and I simply press and hold and I extend and make it as long as I want. I'm going to take it all the way to the end. And if I tap off the image and tap on the gray background, it's going to remove the orange border that's going around the video so I can see actually what it's going to look like. So I'm going to just scrub back and forth to make sure that that's what I want. Okay, so the phone screen is in place. So the next thing we want to do is add the screen recording that we made. So once again, we're going to go into Mixer and we're going to add the screen recording. I'm going to tap on that and it's going to add the screen recording right on top of my image. Now, in order to get this into place, I'm going to press down and I'm going to move it on top of my phone frame. And then I'm going to pinch and I'm going to zoom and slowly increase the size so it fits within the actual phone frame. And you're going to notice if I tap off here, you're going to notice that it's now on top of my phone frame. And this isn't a problem. We're going to fix that right now. What you want to do is scroll all the way over to the right. Make sure that it's actually highlighted. That's going to give you that orangish red look around the actual clip. And then come all the way over to arrange. Tap on arrange and bring it all the way over to the left. What that's going to do is it's going to drop it underneath the actual phone screen. I'm going to tap off again to see how it looks, and I can see that it's a little bit small. So I'm going to tap on it once more in the timeline, and then I'm going to pinch and zoom just a little bit to make it a little bit larger. And then I'm going to tap off. That actually looks pretty good. Now you can see right here that they come in at different times, and we don't want that. We're actually going to fix that right now. But the first thing I want to do is I want to animate this so when they come in, they look pretty cool. So I'm going to tap first on the phone frame and go right down here to the bottom to animation. I'm going to tap on animation. Then I'm going to tap on in. This is how it's going to animate as it enters the screen. I'm going to choose slide left. And if you want to speed up or slow down as it slides in, you can adjust this with the slider right here. But I'm pretty happy with how this is set, so I'm going to keep it. Next thing I'm going to do is tap on the actual clip itself. I'm going to tap on that and go back to animation, tap on in, and choose the exact same slide left. Now both of these are set to slide in from the left, but they're sitting on the timeline in different places. And again, this isn't a problem, so let me show you how to move the clips. I'm going to tap on the actual screen recording, and I'm going to use both of my fingers here on the timeline to expand the timeline. Then I'm going to press the screen recording, hold it down, and I'm going to move it until it matches and snaps up with the actual phone screen. Then as I scrub back and forth, you can see that they both slide in at the exact time. Almost the exact time. So I'm going to keep expanding the timeline. I'm going to press on the screen recording once again. I'm going to press and hold, and I'm going to move it until it snaps into place with the actual phone screen again. Now you can see that it comes in pretty close to the same time, and I'm happy with that. It's actually a little bit smaller, but for the purpose of this tutorial, that's good enough. So if I back it off and I play, you're going to see that it slides right in. Perfect. And that's how you put your phone screen on your video. Now, if you want to take this up a notch, you can take the actual talking head footage and you can move that over as the clip and the phone screen comes in. And that's really easy to do. And I'm going to show you how to do that right now using keyframes. I'm going to go down to the timeline and I'm going to tap on the actual video. And as the phone screen starts to move in, I'm going to expand this a little bit. As it starts to move in here, I'm going to drop a keyframe, and that's this little icon right here. Once the first keyframe is dropped, then I'm going to move over to the right just a little bit here in my timeline. And as it starts to come in, then I'm going to take my finger up onto the actual screen, and I'm going to pinch and zoom, and I'm going to move that over just a little bit. And then as it comes in even more, I'm going to pinch and zoom and move it in just a little bit more, like this. Now, it's automatically going to add those keyframes every time you pinch and zoom because you already set the original keyframe. Now, if I go back and I press play, you're going to notice that I actually move as the screen recording and the phone screen comes in. Now, after you've edited your entire video and you've added your phone screen and your screen recording footage and you're ready to export, simply go up to the top right-hand corner, tap on export, and it's going to give you some options in terms of your resolution and your frame rate per second. Since you're uploading to YouTube, you want your frames per second, your frame rate, to be between 24 and 30 frames per second. When choosing your resolution, crank it up all the way to the right, as high as your phone can possibly take it. I can take it up to 4K. You should probably be able to do that as well. And then when you're ready, tap on photos, and it's going to render your video and save it into your gallery. Then use the YouTube app, go into your gallery, select that video, and upload it to YouTube. If you want to learn more about video editing with your smartphone, go ahead and hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next video.